Hey guys, welcome to Scrap Your Heart YouTube Hop 2020. Kanika Jain this side from Handmade by Kanika. A special thanks to all our sponsors. So we have a giveaway as well. So make sure you participate in the giveaway to win some amazing craft goodies. And today in the tutorial, I shall be making a mini layout. And if you are a beginner and you want to know more about how to make layouts, this is a perfect video for you to watch out. So that's why I made a mini layout and not a big layout. But before moving forward, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification bell so you never miss an update from us. So let's get started. So today we are making a circular layout. So for that I am creating the base using the basic nesting circle dies from Dress My Craft. So from the set of 10 dies, I am taking the third largest die and using my black cardstock, I am die cutting it with the help of my Sizzix Big Shot machine. So just in case if you don't have this die or a die cutting machine, you can simply use your compass and create a circle for the base. So the die size was little bigger than my acrylic plate of the Sizzix Big Shot, so here I have to trim a little bit with my scissors and our base is ready. Now I am using Dress My Craft Magical Unicorns paper pad. If you want to buy all these craft supplies, you can check out the description box as the link to all these is in description box. So I am trimming off my pattern paper using my Dress My Craft Gullet trimmer, and with the same circle size I will be just die cutting the same pattern paper. Also, if you're enjoying watching these DIY video tutorials, then do hit the like button. So we have die cut both of these circles on the same size, but what I'll be doing is with this pattern paper, I will be simply using my Tim Holtz distress tool. This is the paper distress tool, and I will be generously distressing the edges to give it a very worn out look, and this will make sure that this pattern paper size gets a little bit smaller than our base cardstock. And this will give a perfect layering look like this. So now I want to give a little bit 3D look to my pattern paper. So here I'm using 3D foam tape so that there is a little bit of dimension on my base as well. So I'm applying a layer of 3D foam tape on pattern paper and then I will be placing it over onto the black cardstock. This will make sure that I give a very nice layer onto my layout. So while making layouts, you need to make sure that you are layering them and adding a lot of elements so that they look complete. A tip while working with 3D foam tape is that you should always add your liquid adhesive to it to make sure that it sticks on permanently. Like here I'm using my tacky glue and it will make sure that this sticks permanently to my base. So the base of our layout is ready. So as we have distressed the edges, so you can see white paper showing off. So for that here I'm using my distress ink, Victorian Velvet, and with the help of ink blending tool I'm simply distressing the edges. I'm not distressing the edges fully as I want a little bit of white to show so that it blends in with the design of our pattern paper. Now I want to give a little bit of more dimension to the base. So here I have the Dress My Craft Mixed Media Stencil and it is the script design. So giving that, I am using the same distress ink to give textures, and with the ink blending tool I am just randomly inking up, giving it the script pattern on the background which looks like this. So similarly, randomly I will just cover up little more areas with this shade. So the reason I love working with the Dress My Craft stencils is that they are multi-purpose. So here I have another design which I can use, and as well the size of these stencils are just amazing. I'm just randomly stenciling on the base to make our base look more interactive, or you can as well use your archival inks or even texture paste will work. So this is how it looks after all this stenciling. So now moving on to the next step. Here I have my focal point, which is my picture with one of my knees. So it looks a little bit bigger than the size of the layout. So I'm trimming it off using my mini paper trimmer from Dress My Craft. So Scrap Your Heart YouTube Hop will be running out for 2 days. That is, today we have the pre-recorded tutorials and tomorrow you will see some live streams happening on the channels. So now here I have the 3-in-1 corner punch from Dress My Craft, and on the side of 10 mm I am simply chopping off the edges. So while working with layout, you should always first figure out the focal point you want and then work. So here I have 2 pieces of chipboard which I will be placing, and then onto that I will be placing over my picture so that it gives a 3-dimensional look. As layering is must in the layout, so here I have the Dress My Craft Classic Doily die, and onto Golden Mirror cardstock I have done some die cutting, and then I will be placing it over. I'm just figuring out where it would look good. So now I will start sticking up the base. So here I am adding 2 of the layers of the chipboards, and then onto that I'll be placing over the picture so that it gets a very nice 3-dimensional look, and I can add foliage and elements beneath. And when you figure out the focal point, so it's little bit easier for you to work around. So here what I'm doing is between 2 of the chipboards I'm adding the doily die cut so that the doily die cut as well gets a 3-dimensional look, and then onto that I am placing over the picture so you can see a little bit of layering, and it will add different layers so it will look more interactive. Here I have this foliage die from Dress My Craft, and this is how it looks. So using the Victorian Velvet Distress Ink to one of my die cuts, I have colored them, and this is how it looks. Now I will be adding it over on the back side of my focal point to make sure that the layout looks complete, and it will make sure that I get a lot of elements. Another tip while working with the layouts is that before you start adhering all the elements, have a clear-cut idea that what element you will be placing it where so that it's easier for you. So now you can see I was done with the placement of this foliage leaves. So I am using my liquid adhesive and adding them. Now to add more embellishments, here I have some of the mulberry flowers and pollens. So I will be adding them using my hot glue gun. So the reason I like using with hot glue gun for this purpose is that it sticks very fast, and I don't need to wait for my liquid adhesive to dry and I can move on to the next step. So just to add flowers, I use my hot glue gun. And here you can see I'm not using a single size flower, I'm using multiple sizes so that my flower bunch looks perfect, and it will add more beauty than just using one single size flower. You can as well use your buds, like here you can see I have this mulberry bud. So you need to make sure that you're using elements of different sizes and different elements to make your layout look more interesting. Here I have this mini glass bottle, and onto this I will be filling in with the flower pearls. So this is the golden one, and here I have the rainbow crumbs from Dress My Craft. So the reason I'm using the golden flower pearls is that if you notice that we have the classic doily die of golden color, and I want something as well of the same shade so it looks mixed and match and doesn't look very different. So you can see the flowers or the foliage leaves as well I have used as per the color combination. So here you can see I am done adding both of these, and I will close it down and shake it very well so both of them blends very well. And after that I'm just applying a little bit of liquid adhesive. Make sure you use a clear liquid adhesive, and then I will add this. But before that, here I have this clear water droplets. This is the 10 mm one from Dress My Craft itself, and I am placing them to give it more dimensions. So can you see I am using different types of products to make my layout look more interesting? Like here I have this sentiment which says "you are special," which I am adding it here. Now to add more layering to my project, I am using this white foliage die cuts, and I am adding it over here so that the foliage together comes out and the layout looks a little bit more filled up. And then I will be using several other products. Like here you can see I'm using my hot glue gun to adhere it. I'm just using a little bit of hot glue gun, make sure it doesn't oozes out and it would look dirty. So to add little more dimension to my project, here I have the sentiment tiles. So you can use the colored ones like this or as well the white one. So this sentiment tile says smile always, and I'm just figuring out at what position to place them. And now with my liquid adhesive, I'm generously adding the liquid adhesive and then sticking this over. So all these things will add the beauty to your project. Now here you can see I have this sequence. This is the pink pastel sequence from Dress My Craft, and I'm randomly adding my liquid adhesive here and there, and then onto that using my Dress My Craft tweezers I will be adding this sequence. And then to add more interest, here I have this bauble which I made using the plastic balls from Dress My Craft, and have added some shaker elements like the Dress My Craft sequence, and then as well added a motif and a sentiment which says kisses. And then here with the help of my red ribbon twine, I will be hanging it onto my layout. So now to make this bauble go with my layout, what I'm going to do is on this, I'm adding little bit of hot glue and then adding flower on both the sides so that it looks neat and clean, and the flowers are as per the color combination of my layout, so they will go very well. As we have added 3D foam tape and the sides are open, I will simply just fold this side little bit so that I can stick the bauble. Now I'm just adjusting the hanging length, and then what I'm going to do is I'm simply adding a little bit of hot glue, and then from the back side of my tweezers I will be placing it over like this. Make sure you apply a little bit of hot glue, otherwise the glue will ooze out. And then for the excess of ribbon twine, I'm trimming it off. Ta-da, our cute mini layout is ready. So I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. Do hop on to the other channels as well. You can check out the description box for more details. And see you soon. Until next time. Till then, happy crafting.